Today we go on a tofu adventure and try various soft tofu stews. Round one is super duper spicy. Round two is spicy and earthy. We also try plain milky tofu.
안녕 친구! This afternoon, we are in Gangneung, specifically at Tofu Village. Joining us today is...
Hi! Hey, Sven!
Oh, is it raining?
Yeah, you're right! Yeah. It's sprinkling!
First up is Yecheon Yukgaejang Sundubu. Their menu is framed right in front of the door.
Ooh!
Spinach, mackerel, kimchi, sauce, chodubu, seaweed kimchi, fish cake with sausage, radish kimchi, corn salad, seasoned leaves, more kimchi and tofu. Our Yukgaejang Sundubu was coming to a beautiful boil. It came with our Yecheon set menu.
Let's get a little bit of everything. Mushroom, it's a enoki mushroom, the type that is a little bit more clingy to each other. So you really gotta break them loose by zigzagging through it. It's spicy. Whoa, if you have a stuffy nose and you have a sip of this, it'll just like clear it up. My ears feel like... I feel like things are echoing just from one sip. I feel a little faint actually. But I'm a little sensitive to spiciness. Maybe for all of you guys out there, this is an easy eat. I think I need a fire extinguisher. Faye, you gotta try this. I'm curious about your reaction. So Faye has braces, so she gotta be a little bit careful.
Right down.
We could calm down the spice by putting in some rice. Did you get that? I'm a rapper.
Calm down the spice by putting in the rice. Do it twice and make it extra nice.
Still spicy, but not as piercing. The rice eases in the spice.
There are pieces of beef inside.
Every time you have a bite, it's as if you're having it for the first time all over again. The spiciness doesn't die. It just resurrects and resurrects. To me, it tastes like hot Cheetos, but a little bit more sophisticated.
Like a classy hot Cheeto?
Classy hot Cheeto.
It has been jeweled up, blinged up.
Blinged up hot Cheeto.
Gucci hot Cheeto.
There's carrot in that. Carrot and peas. This one is more of a modern side dish. For more traditional side dishes, right here. Typically when you go to Korean restaurants, they will give you seasoned grains. Here we have fish cake. It likes to do acrobatics. And it also comes with sausage in this one. Seaweed and radish kimchi. That one's cooling. We're gonna turn the heat off so the soup doesn't evaporate any further. This here looks like cottage cheese. Quite clumpy. Ooh, it has more flavor than I expected, but still on the mild side.
If you happen to run out of rice, you could use the tofu as your base instead. And here we have a slab of tofu. Ooh, on the firm side.
Ooh, that kimchi is not that spicy. Or maybe because the Yukgaejang Sundubu is so spicy, everything else doesn't taste as spicy. Are you starting to sweat yet?
My nose is running.
I see it, it went over there.
Does this mackerel taste as bold as it looks? Only one way to find out.
It's a little salty, a bit oily, so you're definitely gonna need to have some rice or something to balance that flavor out.
I recommend that you don't wear plain white when you eat here, because look at all the soup splattered onto the table. It looks like, it's like someone took a paintbrush and went like that. Seasoned perilla leaf.
Very salty. Definitely gonna have some.
The only thing we didn't try yet is the radish kimchi.
Ooh, they're huge. Not as eventful as a Yukgaejang Sundubu.
Okay, of all the things you tried here, what is your favorite side dish?
Side dish? The corn.
The corn. And do you like the corn more or the Sundubu?
Sundubu? For sure.
Just realized I didn't try this one yet. That one's more fermented. Tastes more deep and wiser than the fresh kimchi. Do you feel the spice in your soul?
Not no more. When it cools down, it's not as spicy anymore.
It continues to sprinkle, so we brought out our umbrella. Now we're on our way to round two!
Round two!
A couple steps away is Chodang Halmoni Sundubu, but let's digest a bit and explore the area.
Feeling, enjoying, healing. Cafe. There's a Sundubu house over here, over there, and yet over there. There are so many options. Which one should we eat at?
Let's check out the menu of this restaurant. Very big.
There's a queue for this restaurant.
All right, so we have to go inside to get our numbers.
한 20분 정도 기다리셔야 돼요.
Yeah, let's go somewhere else. That place is very popular. But popular doesn't mean it's always the best. So let's move on.
Across the street, another option. And yet another option.
Faye and I are weaving through the parking lot. Jampong Sundubu. Gotta love the waiting area. We have stools and a Christmas tree.
This time we brave the queue. It's the weekend, so no surprise.
Our number is 282. Currently we are on number 247. Faye, the wait is 25 minutes. This tent has one waiting area. Another waiting area around the Christmas tree. Next to the heater, our kitty sleeps. Oh, number!
Near the entrance is a wall of autographs from Korean celebrities.
We made it inside! Holy moly! As you can see, it is packed behind me.
Let's study the menu. They have English translations as well.
Spicy? Or salty?
Please excuse me for spitting the salty gochu out. It was making me way too emotional. Later, I learned this dish is a delicacy and takes time to make. The peppers are stuck directly into doenjang, which is why it's so salty.
It's spicier than the yukgaejang sundubu we had earlier. Also on the salty side, sour, it's refreshing. And we have the yellow radish. Something that is commonly eaten with jjajangmyeon.
The star of the show has made her entrance. Jjampong Sundubu, let's see what you're all about.
As usual, we got the bill before we started eating. Typical thing to happen in a Korean restaurant, so don't get offended. What are we gonna try first? There's so many things. Okay, there's seafood in this. It smells a bit like a burnt wood. It almost tastes like what it smells. The yukgaejang sundubu we had earlier was spicier than this one. However, this one tastes more earthy. Has a more complex flavor. Ooh, you see here, you have mussels.
Other ingredients in this sundubu include woody or mushroom, sesame seeds, scallion, chili flakes, and the tofu looks like the top of a cauliflower.
Oh, it looks like a carrot in that as well. So I was expecting this sundubu to have a strong seafood flavor, but it's actually quite light. It doesn't taste like the ocean. We still don't want to try. Faye is actually not a huge fan of seafood, so that is why she got the plain tofu. See, there's tofu in that as well. Scallion. It's doenjang, soybean paste. It's very strong. We had this chodubu at the other restaurant. Does it taste similar or different? Let's find out. Very similar. If there's a difference, it's very subtle. This also looks plumpy and it looks milky. A little bit murky in a pure way.
Up next, we try PG. A dish made of pureed soaked soybeans.
There seems to be little bits of chili flake. Ooh! The texture of that one is not as smooth as the chodubu. It has a little bit bit more friction. You know the feeling of a cat licking you on the skin and it kind of has like that little pool? It has that kind of texture to it. Let's see how the side dishes are. Okay, simple and clean. Actually, when it comes to the Spanish side dish, I prefer the first restaurant we went to.
I actually prefer this Spanish dish more because it's not as salty.
This is dehydrated radish, rehydrated.
Very crunchy. Although in here it's very lively, a lot of people talking. Faye was able to hear me bite into it from the other side of the table.
On to 멸치 볶음, a childhood favorite.
Anchovies are a little bit tough to chew on, and as usual, a little bit on the salty side. Some people like to season their anchovies with nuts, such as walnuts and almonds. This one is pretty simple.
Let's try the curly leaf.
Very saucy. We definitely want to eat chojubu with that one, or with rice.
I actually prefer the chojubu.
Really?
On a daily basis especially. The curry bowl we're eating, this one has more complexity.
Both restaurants we tried today, they're good in their own ways. I'm actually not a huge fan of seafood, but in this case, it is good. They use a lot of different ingredients. We have assorted textures.
What's your favorite thing you ate at this table?
This one! I finished it!
The kimchi!
Yeah, it's a different kind of kimchi. I really like it. It is lighter in color too. I never had before.
My personal favorite is the peachy. The texture may be a little bit off-putting for some people.
But if you like cat licks, then you won't have any problem. This is gonna sound totally wrong, but it's like French kissing a cat.
At first glance, I thought this was coagulated blood. With a closer look, it seems to be radish. Breaks down like radish. And it absorbs a lot of salty flavor. So when you run out of your side dishes, self-service. Refills! Hope you guys enjoyed eating different types of sundubu with us. So when you visit Gangneung, maybe you could stop by and give it a shot as well. There's a lot of choices.
So many.
So whether you're into seafood or not, whether you're into spicy or not, there's something waiting here for your mouth. Be sure to check out Faye's channel. The links are in the description box. And we will catch you in the next video.
Yay!
안녕!
Nearby, there was a Hanok-style cafe. Mainly, it was a roof that had traditional tiling. The interior felt homey, and thankfully, we found an outlet, the life source of every YouTuber. This cup is peeing in my cup. Because the liquid inside is yellow, it legit looks like urine. This is the last video of the Pyeongchang road trip series. However, stay tuned because there's more to come. We're going on another road trip.